everybody, welcome back to the channel. My name is Zactivate and I hope you guys are having a wonderful day. We are here on episode 8 of the Minecraft 1.16 guide, and yes, we are finally building our enchantment table in this one. But before we get into that, I would like to ask you guys to please wash your hands. It helps you out and helps others out as well, so please do that after this video and let's get right into it. Alright, so I'm here harvesting the carrots because before we actually make our enchantment table today and show you guys the best way to go ahead and do that, we actually need to gather some pigs around and come over here and put the pigs into this brand new pen that I made for them. So yeah, we needed pigs for a reason that I will explain later on in the video, but yeah, we couldn't use cows and sheep, and I just realized I have my mob sounds off, so let's go ahead and just turn that on just a little bit to like 10%, 11% should be good. Let's hear those cows and sheep again. Oh, okay. Haven't heard them in a while, but yeah, we need to get some pigs today for that pen before we do our enchantment table, and I did see one right over here somewhere. So let's go ahead and get this guy, and then we can find one more. Oh my, what are you doing? Okay, emergency. Let's try to get him back in. Oh, we got him. Okay, he almost sacrificed his own life, but let's grab this pig right here. We'll bring him back to the pen. Why is he not following me? Okay, there we go. Yeah, we'll bring him back to the pen now. Oops, I fell into the water. First pig is in. That's perfect. We need to find one more now and we can start breeding these guys. I don't think I saw any else. Let me check out here. Ooh, okay, there's one right here. And oh wow, there's a bunch of pigs out there, but we'll grab this closest guy. We only need two because once we have two, we can definitely just start breeding them. And then after this, I'll show you guys what I actually need the pigs for, but buddy, how did you get in here? This is a little awkward, but let's just go ahead and keep moving here. We'll put this pig inside this pen and then yeah, I'll show you guys. Beautiful, two pigs in here. Let's breed them up and start breeding them. Hopefully we can get a good amount by the end of this episode. And yeah, let me go inside here, and I believe we actually have a problem with Butch. Oh no, we don't. He was a leather worker before, but yeah, that's what we need the raw pork chop for. Yeah, or we could have done 14 chicken, but I think raw pork chop is definitely easier to do. So yeah, we can get 7 raw pork chop for 1 emerald. That's gonna help us out with our emerald trades a lot. So yeah, once we have our pig farm up and running more efficiently than what it is right now, of course, we can start trading with Butch. Yeah, we could do that, but now that we have the pig farm basically ready to go, we just have to wait for the pigs to grow up now and everything like that, we can start talking about our enchantment table. All right, we have most of our materials that we need for the enchantment table, I believe, besides some wood. Let's actually go ahead and grab, I think, whatever, we'll just grab a stack just to be safe. But the first thing we're going to need to do is grab a diamond pickaxe, the first diamond tool of the world. So exciting, right? We could put these away. Actually, I don't know why the emerald was there, but yeah, now we have a diamond pickaxe, which is perfect. And we need to grab some obsidian, and that's going to be the first thing we're going to do. So actually, I have a little, makeshift mine over here that I can actually go all the way down, and there's some obsidian all the way down there. So we're gonna go ahead and grab 3 obsidian, I believe, but we also need to make some for the nether portal, so we'll probably grab a bunch here just so we don't have to come back down, and then we'll come back up and talk about the rest of the things we need to have for the enchantment table. I guess one quick tip while you're mining obsidian, place a water bucket right where you're standing and just mine the obsidian like this. Once the obsidian is mined, the water will take over that block where it was, so you don't lose the obsidian, you don't have any lava trouble or anything like that, and it's just an easier process to get all this obsidian. So yeah, if you guys didn't know this tip, I definitely think it's definitely worth trying out. As you can see, just make sure you don't fall into lava as the water is approaching it, and then you should be all good to go. All right, we grabbed 20 obsidian, which I think is definitely more than enough. We kind of just were mining it mindlessly when not even thinking, but we do need these two diamonds as well as a book. So let's just go ahead and make this all into paper for now. So let's just grab this and then this and make this all into paper. Just like this. Let's see how much we actually get. I think this should be enough. Yeah, that definitely should be enough. And then let's go ahead and create just one book for now. I know we're gonna need more for the bookshelves, but for our enchantment table, we do not need any books besides that one. All right, so to make the enchantment table, you're gonna need 4 obsidian, right, like that, 2 diamonds on the side, and then 1 book on top, and voila, we have our enchantment table. So let's actually go ahead and go up here. Where we're gonna be placing our enchantment table is right here. So we're going to need some bookshelves, so let's go ahead and make a ton of wood here. And the bookshelf should appear here, or I guess not, but to make a bookshelf, oh, it's because we don't have any books. Let's go ahead and make a bunch of those, and then we can make our bookshelves. All right, 47 books, definitely more than we need here. So let's just see how many bookshelves we can make here. 8. Okay, 8, and then we're gonna need a ton more wood to make the rest of them. Let's see how many we can make here. 4 more, and then we still need more wood. Okay, perfect. So we're only gonna need 15 bookshelves total, I believe. Hopefully that's the right number, if I remembered correctly. Let's see how many we can make here. 15, so that should be enough to get it done. So we're gonna place our enchantment table right in the middle of the room, just right here like that, and then we could clear out all of this, and then as well as these blocks right here. We're going to have one problem that we need to fix, and it's going to be right here underneath this lower block right here, because you can see out into the rest of the town over there, because that's the wall block of my house, which is unfortunate. We have to figure out a plan for this, but we could do that later on in the episode. For this side right here, I'm not too worried because it's still on the inside of our house technically. So I have an idea of what we can do. And yeah, so basically you're gonna wanna place your bookshelves around the enchantment table, one block of space in between. And then you could just check the enchantments as you go. As you can see, only level 18 for now. Yeah, so you can place them kind of in any order that you want. Just make sure that they are reaching the enchantment table. So yeah, let's just see, this should be level 30. Yes, it is, perfect. So we are going to need just 2 more or 3 more bookshelves just to give it the full length here. So we're just gonna wait for some sugarcane, I guess, to grow, and I guess we should go to sleep. So yeah, maybe the sugarcane is ready to harvest in there, but probably not. We need to wait a little bit probably, and then finish these bookshelves. And then we'll have the full, well, we have the full enchantment table, but then we'll have the full enchantment table set up that I want. But yeah, we have to wait a little bit. All right, while we are waiting, I guess we can harvest our wheat because it's ready to grow. And yeah, like I said earlier, we're just waiting for the sugarcane to grow a little bit so we can get a little more paper to finish off that full enchantment setup for that top part. I mean, we could do some other stuff that I need to do eventually. I guess we could try to solve the problem about this area right here. Oh no, that looks so ugly. Okay, I think I might have a solution to this, but it's gonna take a little bit of spruce wood and we could try something. Let me see something. All right, 10 spruce trap doors should do the trick. Let's just get some building blocks so we can get up there. And if you didn't pick up what I'm trying to do already, you'll see in 1 second here. I guess we could just come up all the way over here somewhere on this one side, and then just shift over to this tree. That should be good. And then try to just place spruce trap doors all along this one block. Okay, we definitely have enough here. Oops, that was one too many. Let's just break that. Let's just break our scaffolding right here too, so we can take a look from a farther distance, just to see if that looks good. It might give it some depth as I break that flower by accident, but I think it might be too much spruce, which is unfortunate. I do want to okay, put it on the board. One squid. All right, first this episode, one squid. But like I was saying, I do think it might be too much spruce. Okay. Is that too much spruce? Let's see. It kind of matches this little area too that we're hiding the bookshelves as well. I guess. I mean, it does make it look a little worse, which is unfortunate, but it will have to do, I believe. Let me see. Let's look from on over here. Yeah, I wish we could do the oak, but the problem is with the oak trapdoors is they actually are see-through, and we'll be using those on the inside. We can go ahead and make a couple of those right now, because we are using them on the inside. Let's see, do we have any extras sitting around here? No, we do not. So let's go ahead and just make a, I think this should be a good amount. We just need probably like 10 or around that. Let's just see. So I'll show you guys what I'm gonna do with these right now, while we're waiting for the sugarcane to grow. We're just gonna place them right here on these bookshelves, just like this, and then when we get these two, we'll put them in like that. So it kind of gives it like they're holding the bookshelves on the other side, but we can still see through, and it's going to give it I think a nice texture from the outside window. That's the most important spot from when I was looking at that wall. So let's just take a look. Let's see, from out here, can we really see it? Okay, yeah, that's gonna look good, I think. Hopefully that does, but let's just wait for the sugarcane to grow here. One just did, but we need to wait a little bit, and then yeah, we'll be able to build those bookshelves. All right, our three bookcases are finally here, and we could just go ahead and put the last trap doors on these. And I'm definitely satisfied with the idea that I came up right here with the bookshelves being covered by those trapdoors. On the other side, not so much. On this side right here, it's unfortunate, but we have to live with it. And yeah, it's becoming nighttime, so we're gonna go ahead and sleep right here, and then yeah. All right, so our enchantment table is now completely set up right here, and yeah, I'm happy with the way it looks right now. So yeah, that's gonna be the enchantment table in this starter house. Now what we're gonna need to do is actually go into our chest right here, and we're gonna check our enchants. We do have 36 levels. That is good. The only thing I think worth enchanting right now is definitely just this diamond pick. So we're gonna check this diamond pick, maybe a book too, so we can check the book as well. So this is Unbreaking 3. Do we want to take the chance on Unbreaking 3? Not too sure if I want to do that. Protection 3, that might be a good book. We'll actually take this book, Protection 3. Looting 2 as well, which is not bad, but obviously can't use those together. So yeah, Protection 3, I guess we can definitely throw that onto one of our early pieces of armor until we get Protection 4. Let's see. Unbreaking 3 again. Do we want to take that risk? Let's look at a book. Power 4. Okay, do we take Power 4? We could take Power 4, but I'm not too sure. I do want to get this pickaxe enchanted here, so maybe we'll actually just take a projectile protection book and throw this diamond pickaxe again here. Fortune 3. Okay, we definitely want Fortune 3 on this, so we're gonna take it. Yes, okay, Efficiency 4, Unbreaking 3, Fortune 3. One of the best pickaxes I feel like you can get from an enchantment table. That is absolutely perfect, and we have 29 levels left. Let's just check what our book is, Restoration 3. Okay, that's perfect, but yeah, we needed a Fortune 3 pickaxe to obviously get more diamonds. And like we went to earlier, I actually have to show you guys something very, very cool in a second here, all the way down here. And I think you guys know what I'm going to be talking about, because we just got fortune, so you know what we need those for. But I'll show you guys in a second here. All right, I think you guys can see it down the strip mine hall. But yeah, we did find diamonds probably 2 episodes ago. I would say around that. Sometimes just off camera, when I need cobblestone or something like that for a build, I'll come down to Y11, and I definitely recommend you guys all do that too. So yeah, we're at Y11 here, and when we need cobblestone, instead of mining it up there like Y40 or something, why not mine it down here when you have the chance of getting diamonds? So yeah, if you guys definitely need some cobble or some other blocks, I definitely recommend that. Or if you're just looking for diamonds and don't want to find it in a cave, you could definitely find it during the strip mine. So yeah, with our Fortune 3 pickaxe right here, hopefully we get a good amount of diamonds. From 4, I would say 10 would probably be good. Hopefully we get 10. Anything in the double digits, I think will be good. So let's see. Let's mine this one. First one, 2. Okay, not too bad. Then we just got a 1. Okay, that's pretty bad. Let's see another one. Let's see. Oh, okay, 4. That was perfect. That kind of helped us a lot. And let's see. Hopefully we can get 3 in this. That would be great. Okay, just 1. All right. So we doubled our diamonds, which is not bad. 8 is definitely solid. We probably should have guessed around that range as well. Double is really I guess around what Fortune would give, but 8 diamonds definitely good enough to build a chest plate. Maybe we could do that in this episode. I'm thinking about it, and I don't know if I want to build a sword or a chest plate first. Or we could just wait until the next episode and start enchanting that, or just later episodes down the line when we start enchanting better diamond and netherite gear once we enter the nether and everything like that. But yeah, that is a little ways away. Also, I know this is a terrible strip mine staircase right there. We definitely have to fix that, but yeah, just disregard that. But I think that's going to be the episode. We finished with 8 more diamonds, 3 more than we started with this episode with, and we built an enchantment table and a diamond pickaxe, which is nice. We can keep, I guess, these books right in here. The projectile protection one is not that good. The protection 3 we'll keep in here. We can move this book in here as well. So we're going to clean out our inventory here and end this episode off. Not the most intense episode, but something we definitely needed to get done because our we need enchantments and we need an enchantment table. So I'm glad we got that done. As always, please leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you're new to the channel. It really, really helps me out. Hopefully this episode wasn't too short. I know the last couple months have been longer episodes because we were building a bunch of structures like our starter house and our sugarcane farm and stuff like that. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this one, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.